Hi, good morning, everybody. Welcome back to Ms. Farah's online class. Hope you had a great weekend. I know I did. I got a lot of rest, which was really needed. I hope you did as well, and that you got to spend time with your family and maybe play outside a little bit. It was great to see some of y'all at the car parade and on Zoom. That was really fun. We're going to try to do Zoom lessons at least every Friday, just so I can say hi to everybody again. So make sure that you are trying to get on Fridays. It'll always be on Fridays at 1 o'clock. This morning, we're gonna go over our sight words, and then I'm just gonna go over what we're gonna do for the day so y'all can get started. All right, so today is, let's see if we can move that glare away. Maybe a little bit or not. All right, today is Monday. It's kind of hard to see, but it's M-O-N-D-A-Y, Monday. Today, the month is April. The day of the month is the 27th, and the year is 2020. So we're about to be into a new month. So after April is, what month would come after April? May, very good. So it's April and then May. All right, we have some new sight words this morning, and we have some old sight words this morning because we like to review a little bit of a mix of the two. So our first sight word that we have this morning is make. Make. It's M-A-K-E, make. Now remember, the E on the end is silent. It changes the A to make a different sound. M-A-K-E, make. Number two is time. Time. T-I-M-E, time. And again, we have that silent E on the side. Number three is into. So if you cover up one, it's going to say two. And if you cover up the other side, it's going to say in. We put it together, it's into. I-N-T-O, into. Number four we had last week. It's why, why, W-H-Y, why. Number five is would. Remember, it's not wood like the trees, it's wood like, would you help me? It's W-O-U-L-D, wood. Number six is keep, like keep trying, K-E-E-P, keep. Remember, we have those two E's again together. We don't say the sounds twice, it makes one sound, keep. Number seven looks kind of like make, but it's made, made. M-A-D-E, made. And again, you have that silent E that changes the A sound. Number eight is each, each, E-A-C-H. Remember the C-H on the end is that digraph that makes a ch-ch-ch sound, so each. This one's a little tricky because we have two vowels right next to each other. And remember, when two vowels are next to each other, the first one does the talking. So each. Really, really makes two sounds, but there's four letters. So that one's a really tricky one. Number nine is find, like help me find our work. F-I-N-D, find. And number 10 is first. Again, we have a little digraph kind of on the end. It's a st sound. It's gonna make a different sound. F-I-R-S-T, first. All right. So make sure today that you are looking at your sight words again and write them three times. Write them three times. So once you are done with your sight words, you can go ahead and take a picture and send it to Ms. Farah, or you can post it on your profile. Make sure you're writing your sight words three times today. That will be what we are doing for sight words. And then for phonics, we are talking about word families this week. So word families are, they all rhyme, remember? So whenever we talk about rhyming words, they all end the same way, or they all begin the same way, or they all have a middle of the same one. So today we're gonna be talking about the at sound, at. Now, can we think of a couple letter words that make the at sound? I know we know quite a bit because we've looked at this before, so we should know what they are. So we could have b-at, so bat, b-at, remember the at is on the end. What about m-at, mat, m-at, so the at is on the end again. Let's think of one more that we can together. Maybe pat, at, pat, Again, the at sound is on the end. So that is our word families that we're going to look over today. So while you're at home, I want you to think of 5 words. You can use some of my words, but try to think of your own words that end with an at sound or have an at sound in them. That's perfectly fine. Okay, we have a lot to do this week as far as reading and writing goes. Sorry, Lily would like to say hi to everybody. Say hi, Lily. She's really excited whenever I talk to y'all. She really likes saying hi to y'all. So I remember on the Zoom meeting, everybody got to say hi to Lily, and she loved getting on and saying hello. But right now, she's being a little bit much. So today in reading and writing, you have a lot to get done. In reading, I want you to look at a book today and try to figure out what the author's purpose is going to be. Now, remember, their purpose is why they wrote the book. So why would they write it? It's good for us to set a purpose for reading. So are you reading the story to learn about something, or are you learning about it for fun? So try to look at the story that you're reading about with either your parents, or you can read it on Myon, either one, and try to think about what the author's purpose is for the story, what your purpose is for reading it. So when we read The Very Hungry Caterpillar last week, was that for learning or is that for fun? For fun, right? It has some learning in it, but we were reading it as fun. But whenever we're reading like informational texts about stuff, is that for learning or for fun? It's for learning, right? It's for learning. So you want to make sure that you can tell the difference between the two books. And after you read the book, I want you to try to remember who the characters were and what happened in the story. So what was the story about? So look at who the characters were and what was the story about, because that'll help you remember the whole story. So you need to be able to retell the story or think about what the story was today. So try to do that together. And then in writing, we're going to start writing a letter today. So you're going to start writing a letter to somebody at our school. So you need to be somebody at our school, maybe a mom or dad or a sibling, but somebody that we know in our class, somebody that's around our classrooms. You can't write it to the president. That's a lot. It needs to be somebody that's at our school or that has something to do with our school, okay? So when you write an opinion, you tell somebody something about how you feel or think about something. So you could say, I think, or maybe I like, or my favorite thing is. So, and you need to put the reason why you feel or think the way that you do. So maybe you could say, my favorite ice cream is chocolate because I think it's the best flavor in the world. It's an opinion. So today you can look at what an opinion is, and then I want you to start thinking about who you're going to write your story to or write your letter to. So it could be to our principal or maybe Miss Putman, because everybody loves Miss Putman at our school, or you could write it to Miss Farah or your parents, somebody that has to do with our school, and you're gonna write about what plants you think that we should plant in our garden at school. So whenever you're thinking about it, you could write it as a bubble chart, a bubble map, sorry, not bubble chart, a bubble map. So you could say the person's name maybe in the middle or the idea in the middle, right? So you could say maybe plants. That's what we want to decide, is what plants we want to write in, or we want to have in our garden. So I'm going to write my story to Miss Gomez, because she is our principal. Sorry, Miss Gomez's name up there. Oops, sorry. And then you need to start thinking about what kind of plants that you want to put. So maybe I want sunflowers, because I really liked our sunflowers that we grew. Or maybe I want tomatoes. So I can say either one of those. And why do I want those things? So start thinking about why you want any of those. So I want sunflowers because they're pretty. And I want tomatoes because they look cool to grow, because you can grow them upside down. So it's pretty cool. So up here you could write about, you could say maybe the reasons why. So they're pretty. So start to organize your ideas for why you want to do something. So why should we do this? Start thinking about it. Think about who you want to write your story to. And then online today, I'm going to post a picture of a writing piece that you can do just to practice writing an opinion or filling in a blank for an opinion, either one. Make sure that you are getting on Imagine Learning twice every day. So try your hardest. Last week we did pretty well, but other classes were doing so much better. They were getting more time online. So make sure that you're getting on Imagine Learning. It makes me really happy, and it's the best way that you can keep up with your schoolwork at home. It's great to do twice a day. If you can't do it twice a day, at least try to get on once a day, maybe for 15 minutes for reading and 15 minutes for math. That's perfectly fine too. So make sure that we're trying to remember to do it. Don't forget, Friday we're going to have our Zoom meeting. So at 1 o'clock on Friday, please get online. I'm going to make a event about it today so that way that we can all remember. And please make sure that we are paying very close attention to our parents when we're at home, because they are the ones that are helping us learn right now, because I can't be with you at home. But if you have any questions, you can always call Ms. Farah or send me a message. That's perfectly fine. But please make sure that you're listening to your parents and working hard for them. It's really hard for them, and it will make it so much better if you're very, very kind to them all day long. Keep up the hard work. You're making me very happy. Later today, I'll post a short read aloud of a fun book that we can all read together. And again, if you have any questions, let me know. All right, y'all have a great day. I'll see you later. Bye.